Hello everyone, my name is Natesh Puttalingappa. In this teaching and learning series, we are discussing the solutions for Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya Selection Test 2020, that is Class 6 JNVST 2020. Today, let us continue our discussion of solutions for arithmetic test in Section 2. Come on, let's begin. Question number 46. Amit bought a table for ₹1,200 and spent ₹200 on its repair. He sold it for ₹1,680. His profit or loss percent is? Here, Amit has bought an old table for ₹1,200 and spent ₹200 on its repair. After repairing, it has got a new appearance like this, and then he sold it for ₹1,680. We have to find his profit or loss percent. The given data in the problem is cost price is equal to ₹1,200 plus ₹200. On adding, we get the total cost price as ₹1,400. And the selling price is equal to ₹1,680. On comparing the cost price and the selling price, we find that the selling price SP is greater than the cost price CP. Therefore, Amit must have gained some profit. So, the amount of profit he has gained can be found by subtracting the cost price from the selling price. On doing so, we get the profit as ₹280. To find the profit percent, we have the formula. Profit percent is equal to profit divided by cost price CP into 100. Now let us substitute the values and simplify. Profit is ₹280 divided by cost price is 1400 into 100. So we cancel these two zeros with these two zeros here, and dividing 280 by 14. 14 ones are 14, 14 twos are 28, and we put one zero here. Therefore, profit percent is equal to 20%, which is in answer option D. In answer option C, we have 20% loss, but Amit has gained some profit. Therefore, answer option D, 20% profit is the correct answer. We mark it on the OMR answer sheet corresponding to the question number 46. The answer option D is the correct answer. Now let us move to the next question. Question number 47. 140.75 into 0.01 is equal to. We have to find the product of these two decimal numbers. So here what we have is 140.75 into 0.01. So on multiplying this number by 1, we get 14075. And to place the decimal point, we need to count the number of digits towards the right of the decimal point in both of these numbers. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So we put decimal point after 4 digits from right. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the required answer is 1.4075, which is in answer option C. So let's mark answer option C as the correct answer for question number 47 and move to the next question. Question number 48. 1/4 of birds of a flock are at a river bank and 1/5 of that flock are in their nest. Remaining 22 birds are wandering in search of food. What is the number of birds which are in their nest? Let the total number of birds in the flock be equal to x. And some birds are at the river bank. So, the number of birds at the river bank BR is equal to x by 4, which is given in the question. Some birds are in their nest. So, the number of birds in their nest BN is equal to x divided by 5. And some birds are wandering in search of food. So, the number of birds wandering in search of food, BW, is equal to 22, which is given in the question. Now, we have to find the number of birds in their nest. So, for that, what we do is, the total number of birds in the flock is x. So, the total number of birds in the flock must be equal to number of birds at the river bank, that is BR, plus the number of birds in the nest, BN, plus the number of birds wandering in search of food, BW. So, if you add the number of birds at the river bank, number of birds in the nest, and the number of birds wandering in search of food, this sum must be equal to the total number of birds we have assumed as x. Let us substitute these values and find the value of x first and then the number of birds in their nest, that is x by 5. So, we write x as it is, which is to be found. X is equal to BR is the number of birds at the river bank, which is x divided by 4. So, we write x divided by 4 plus number of birds in the nest is x by 5, x divided by 5 plus the number of birds wandering in search of food, BW, is equal to 22. So, we write 22 here. Since we need to find the value of x, let us take the terms containing x to the left hand side. On doing so, what we get? X minus x by 4 minus x by 5 will be equal to 22. Let us simplify this. LCM of 4 and 5 will be 20. So, in the denominator, let us have 20. In numerator, what we get is, it will be 20x, since the denominator is 1, minus, it will be 5x, 5 for the 20, minus, this will be 4x, 4, 5 is a 20, which will be equal to 22. Here, in the numerator, so minus 5x and minus 4x will be minus 9x. Subtracting 9x from 20x, we get 11x divided by 20 will be equal to 22. And 11 ones are 11, 11 twos are 22. And taking this 20 to the right hand side, it will become 2 into 20. Therefore, x is equal to 2 into 20 is 40. That is, the total number of birds in the flock is equal to 40. But this is not the required solution. We are asked to find the number of birds in the nest. So, x divided by 5 is the number of birds in their nest. Since we found the value of x, that is 40, let us substitute here. 40 divided by 5. On dividing 40 by 5, we get 8. Therefore, 8 is the required answer for this question. Looking back at the question, we find that in answer option D, answer 8 is given, which is the number of birds in their nest. So, let us mark answer option D as the correct answer for question number 48 on the OMR answer sheet and move to the next question. Question number 49. In how many years does the sum of rupees 1200 become rupees 1800 at the rate of simple interest of 5% per annum? In this problem, we have to find the number of years in which a principal amount of rupees 1200 becomes an amount of rupees 1800 at the rate of simple interest of 5% per annum. Let us write down the given data, that is principal amount P is equal to rupees 1200. The amount 1800 rupees is the principal amount and the simple interest which is obtained after certain number of years at the rate of simple interest 5% per annum. Therefore, principal amount plus simple interest is equal to rupees 1800. And the rate of interest R is equal to 5% per annum. And we need to find the number of years in which we get 1800 rupees for principal amount 1200 rupees, which is to be found. I put a question mark here. The formula for simple interest is simple interest SI is equal to PTR by 100. Let us substitute this formula into this equation here. Let me call this as equation number 1. And now equation number 1 becomes, we have P plus, in the place of SI, I write PTR by 100 is equal to rupees 1800. I write 1800. Now let us substitute the values and simplify. Principal amount P is 1200 plus, again I write 1200 here, R is 5%, 5, and at the end I write T here. In denominator we have 100 is equal to 1800. Amounts are in rupees, time will be in years. So dividing 1200 by 100, these two zeros get cancelled, and 12 into 5 is 60. I take this 1200 to the right hand side. So on left hand side, what is remaining is 60T is equal to, so taking this to the right hand side becomes minus 1200. Subtracting 1200 from 1800 will be 600. So dividing this, I get 10. Therefore, T is equal to 10. That means the principal amount rupees 1200 will become rupees 1800 at the rate of simple interest of 5% per annum in 10 years. Therefore, answer option A, 10, is the correct answer. Let us mark it on the OMR answer sheet. Answer option A is the correct answer for question number 49. Let's move to the next question. Question number 50. How many bricks will be required for a wall 8 meter long, 6 meter high and 22.5 centimeters thick if each brick measures 25 centimeters into 11.25 centimeters into 6 centimeters? Here we have a brick wall constructed using several bricks. Dimensions of the wall and the dimensions of the brick are given in the question. We have to find how many bricks of the given dimensions are required to construct the wall of given dimensions. Dimensions of the wall are length L is equal to 8 meter, height H is equal to 6 meter and thickness T is equal to 22.5 centimeters, which are given in the question. Let us record these data at one side, length, height and thickness of the wall. Here what we notice is thickness of the wall is given in centimeters, whereas the length and heights are given in meters. We need all of these in one unit. And also, since the dimensions of a brick are given in centimeters, let us convert the units in meters into centimeters. We know that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. Therefore, 8 meter will be equal to 800 centimeters. And 6 meters will be equal to 600 centimeters. Now we have all the dimensions in centimeters. Similarly, let us write down the dimensions of brick also.
Length of the brick is 25 centimeters, which is given here. And height of the brick is 11.25 centimeters, which is given in the question here. And the thickness of the brick is 6 centimeters, which is given here.
We have recorded all the given data appropriately with correct units. Now, to find the volume of the wall, we make use of the formula volume of a cuboid is equal to length into breadth into height. In this case, it will be length into height into thickness. So here, to find the volume of the wall will be equal to number of bricks into volume of a brick. Since several bricks are used to construct the wall, volume of the wall will be equal to volume of a brick into number of bricks used to construct the wall. We write the formula using appropriate symbols. Volume of the wall VW is equal to number of bricks N into volume of the brick VB. Since we need to find the number of bricks used, we rewrite the formula as N is equal to VW divided by VB. Now, let us substitute these values and find the number of bricks used to construct the wall. So, I write number of bricks N is equal to, in the numerator we have VW, that is volume of the wall. Volume of the wall can be found by multiplying length of the wall, height of the wall, and thickness of the wall. So we write these quantities in the numerator. Since all the quantities are in centimeters, I eliminate the unit. Just I write 800 into 600 into 22.5 divided by. In denominator, we have VB, that is volume of a brick. Volume of a brick can be found by multiplying the dimensions of the brick, that is length, height and thickness of the brick. So I write these numbers in the denominator as product, that is 25 into 11.25 into 6. Now let us simplify this fraction. Here this 600 can be divided by 6. So 6 1 times. And 600 times is 600. And then this 100 can be divided by 25. 25 1 times. 25 4 times is 100. We get 4 here. And this 22.5 can be divided by 11.25. So 11.25 1 times. 11.25 2 times becomes 22.5. So now multiplying 4 and 2. 4 2 is 8. And 8 into 8 is 64, and we have two zeros here. Therefore, 64 and two zeros written towards right, 6400. Therefore, the number of bricks used to construct the wall of given dimensions will be equal to 6400. Coming to the question again, in answer option C, we have 6400. Let us mark it on the OMR answer sheet. So we mark answer option C as the correct answer for question number 50 on the OMR answer sheet.
So I hope you understood the solutions of all the questions discussed in today's video. I will come with the solutions of some more questions in my next video. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share and subscribe my channel to get notifications of my new videos as I upload. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.